Good evening, viewers. This is the news you have been waiting for. Early this week, a man was arrested for allegedly killing his fellow business partner. It was reported that there was an issue that occurred between them in which the said business partner, by the name Adams Collins, slapped him. In an attempt to retaliate, it was reported that he pushed Adams and he fell, hitting his head on the floor and died. The man, Goodness Elliott, was arrested and had been in the custody of the police. The case was, however, tried in court today and had been found guilty of murder. The court ordered a judgment of death by hanging. We want to appreciate our viewers for subscribing to our YouTube channel, and for those that hasn't done so, should click the subscribe button. That's all we have today. Thanks for staying tuned. I am your host, Ella.
Good day, everyone. Your letter from every sector has reached the governor, and he has sent me as his delegates. What do you want from the governor?
We are grateful for the privilege, sir. We do not take it lightly. Our coming here is because of the man who mistakenly pushed his business partner. He is the youth leader in our community. He is a responsible and easygoing man. He is loved by all. He couldn't have done this intentionally.
Please, help us to plead with the governor. It wasn't a deliberate plan. He is a nice person.
In fact, every youth from our community has been disturbing us. That's why I wrote to the governor. Let the governor release him. It wasn't deliberate, and we would much be grateful if our request can be granted.
I will channel your plea to the governor, and I hope for a favorable response from him. Your Excellency, sir, concerning the meeting you instructed me to attend, the plea was on behalf of one man that mistakenly killed his business partner.
I have read a lot about him from the letter they wrote. I will see what I can do to it.
What's your plan, sir?
Don't worry, you can leave.
Okay, sir. Your Excellency, sir.
Please, have your seat.
Yes, sir. Your Excellency, sir, I'm surprised.
What do you mean?
Your haircut, your glasses, your clothes. I almost couldn't recognize you, sir. Your Excellency, what do you want from me? You should have called me over to your office.
I came to visit a friend of mine here in your custody.
Ha.
His name is Goodness Elliott, who mistakenly killed his business partner. I came to release him and not to die by hanging. But before I hand over the letter, I would like to preach to him. If he listens, I will hand over the letter to you, otherwise, would be left to face his doom.
Yes, sir.
I have been informed that you have a visitor.
Who?
You get to know when you see the person.
Hello, friend. How are you doing?
I am fine. Who are you? And what do you want from me?
I have seen your pain and I have decided to set you free. But we'll first like to preach to you.
Please, hold it. Who are you to set me free? I have a lot of pastor in my family. What do you want to say that I haven't heard before? Please, let me be.
My friend, calm down and let me talk.
Mr. Stranger, I am not interested in your nonsense preaching.
Since you are not interested in my preaching, I will have to take my leave now. Good day, friend.
Good day. Congratulations. What is going on? And who was that stranger? Stranger? That's the governor. You are very lucky. He left his office and he's here just to set you free. What? I didn't know he is the governor. I thought it was one of those useless people carrying Bible up and down preaching. I am doomed. Didn't give him a listening ears. He had to leave because I was not ready to listen to his preaching. Oh, I have missed it. I will have to face my doom. Had I known, I would have listened to what he wanted to say. Sorry, Case, you have to go back to the cell and await your doomed day. It's time. Oh my God, I won't be dying as a murderer, but as someone who rejects mercy. Oh, how foolish I am.